This meeting is called to order by Lori Canal at 5:30 PM on January 11th, 2023. Okay, call to the public. Residents of the city of Bisbee may speak at this time. What am I supposed to do? Call, oh yeah, I'm sorry. Roll call, board members. Ed Briggs, absent. Peter Gafford?
Present.
Stephen Green?
Here.
Lori Canal, here. Ben Lepley?
Here.
Scott Perfect?
Here.
Ted Schriever?
Here.
Frank Davis, council?
Here.
Staff liaison, Joe?
Here.
Okay, thank you, everybody. Okay, now I will make a call to the public. The residents of the city of Bisbee may speak at this time regarding any design review board topics that are not on the agenda tonight. And if anybody would like to speak, you have a three-minute limit. Anyone? Okay. Nobody is going to speak, so I will close the call to the public. We have a few items of old business. I apologize to those present to put you through this, but we'll go quickly. Agenda item number one, application 22-83108 Tombstone Canyon. Okay, so we have a, I'm gonna open to the public hearing. Does anybody have public comments in favor or against this application? Okay, no. Close the public hearing. Staff comments?
I don't think we have any, do we?
Okay, no staff comments. I will open the board discussion.
If there is any.
If there is any. Any discussion by the board? No. Okay, I would like the board to take a motion on this item, 22-83108 Tombstone Canyon.
Since I made a motion last time, I will repeat it, Mr. Gafford. That's me. Approve application 22-83 with the provision that the panels are placed inconspicuously in rear of house and revised plans are submitted to the building inspector prior to installation.
Do we have a second?
I'll second.
Mr. Perfect seconds. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, all against say nay. No nays. The motion is passed unanimously.
I abstained.
Oh, you abstained, I'm sorry.
Yeah, because I wasn't there that first.
Okay, and Mr. Lepley abstains. So application 22-83 is passed unanimously by the board. Okay, moving along. Agenda item number two. Application 22-8421 Tembe Avenue. This is a solar installation application. I will declare the public hearing open and receive any public comments at this time, either for or against this application. Anybody? Okay, close the public hearing. Staff comments?
No.
None? Okay, board discussion is open. And board discussion is closed, so we will take a motion. Anyone? Okay, I will make a motion to retroactively approve application 22-84.
I'll second that.
Okay, that is seconded by Mr. Gafford. Okay, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All against say nay. No nays. And one abstain, Mr. Lepley. The motion is passed. 5-1. Okay, do I need to say the number?
No, that's fine.
Okay, we're good. All right, agenda, moving on to agenda item number three, application 22-87148 Key Avenue. So this is an application to demolish the existing roof, rebuild at 36 inches height above the current roof line to provide for habitable space on the second floor. Okay, I will open the public hearing. Any comments for or against this application? Okay, close the public hearing. Staff comments, 148 Key?
None.
None? Okay, and then board discussion is open. Anybody have anything to say about this? Okay.
I'd like to have just a little bit of a discussion about this.
Okay, certainly.
I made the motion to approve this. I'm gonna change my vote on this one. I know that it's not gonna be anything, but I just want to go on record as changing my vote on this one. So if someone else could make the motion.
Okay.
Since I made it before.
All right, yes.
I'll make the motion.
Mr. Gaffer makes the motion. Go ahead.
To approve application 22-87, as is with the condition a demolition permit is done and submitted to Mr. Ward, building inspector.
Okay, do we have a second?
A second.
Mr. Schriever seconds. Okay, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All against say nay.
Nay.
That's 3-2.
No, it's 3-3, so that vote is a no, and he's already been given permission to get the demolition permit because Mr. Lepley's gonna abstain.
Oh, Mr. Lepley's abstaining, that makes it 3-3?
Yeah.
And Mr. Briggs did vote in favor last time, but he's not here.
He is not here. So it is up to Mr. Lepley if he would like to vote or not. I mean, I know he's abstained, but if we do that, then 148 Key has already been given permission to do the demolition permit. Because we made the mistake of the public hearing. So I don't believe that he can change his vote. I think it has to stay the same. It has to stay the same.
Why does it have to stay the same?
Because the vote already happened. What didn't happen was the public hearing part.
Right.
So the voting, even though we have to do it again because it's part of the public hearing, needs to be the same as it was, even if somebody else can make the motion, but the vote doesn't change. The voting doesn't change. It's the opening and closing.
I understand that the wheels are in motion for this project.
Right.
But I wanted to go on record as saying, nay, I don't want to vote for it, but the impetus is on board because we screwed up.
Correct.
Yeah.
But because we have to do the vote again, because we had to open the public hearing, you are now nullifying the void. If we go 3-3, then it nulls everything that you did prior.
But what does that do to his project?
That means we did mess up, we did give him permission, and we'd have to do it again. We'd have to do this whole thing again.
I was going to, your statement, that I would just go with the vote, otherwise it's going to cause a lot of problems.
And I can note on the minutes.
Yeah, what would you note?
That, you know, you did have
Reservations.
Reservations.
Oh, okay.
But it would still have to be the 4-1 because I think Lori was.
I was the only nay.
Right, she was the only nay. Yes?
I thought an abstain would be the same as if I was absent.
No, abstain means a no.
Oh.
Abstain means a no.
And this application is not like the other one in that the footprint remains exactly the same. It's just there are
He specifically said what they were demolition. He's not adding anything other than a height.
So how do I just not vote?
You don't have to vote if you don't want to. I'm just saying your abstain vote is a no.
Okay, that's so what I thought the word abstain meant was I'm not voting on this.
No, it automatically means a no.
Okay.
So if he just doesn't vote.
Right, it's
still a no.
It's still a no.
Because he's here.
Oh, I see.
But if he leaves the room.
Unfortunately, we did have him, he's attended the meeting, so we can't do that. So I can note on here that you have reservations, but that we're going to go with the same that for this project.
Put strong reservations.
Okay.
Thanks.
Should we vote again?
Yes, please.
Okay. We have a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye
with reservations.
Okay. So we're going to do that as 4-1 still.
Yes, 4-1. All against say nay. Nay. And then we have one abstain, Mr. Lepley. So that makes it 4-2, and the application passes 4-2. Okay, thank you everybody for putting up with that. Agenda item number four, new business, application 22-73, 161 Quality Hill Road. Owner is Julie A. Goldstrom, and this is seeking retroactive approval for demolition of a carport and the new construction of the carport to be in the exact same site with same simple design and matching building materials. And noting that a stop work order was issued by Mr. Ward. Yes. Okay, so I will open the public hearing for application 22-73. Anybody here?
We're gonna call for the application first, sorry.
Oh, so, I'm sorry.
If you'll follow the.
The owner or representative may come up and present their case. You go right up here to the podium.
Go up here to the podium.
Thank you, sorry.
We can push that down.
It's okay.
It's so high. There we go.
I actually drove that here today.
The only thing I have to say is we went to repair it. I did not realize I needed a permit. And we started to fix it and it collapsed. It's been there since I bought the house in '86. And we're building it exactly the same way, the same material. Everything is still the same. It just got old and fell apart.
Can I ask a question? What were the materials that the carport that fell apart?
The same. It was wood with aluminum. And the roof is all the same. The wood, mainly wood.
It was a wood frame.
Yeah, wood frame.
With a corrugated metal roof?
Yes. No, was it corrugated? Yeah.
Okay. Well, it goes like this.
Yeah. But it went like that. But it's been there since I bought in '86, so.
Okay, thank you. Okay, now I will open this public hearing. Any statements for or against the application?
I do have the two that were in the packet.
Okay.
One was opposed to the rebuilding of the carport, and the other one was in favor.
Okay, thank you. And anything else? Okay, I will declare the public hearing closed. And any staff comments related to this? Mr. Ward, do you have anything?
I'm going to stay neutral on it.
Okay. All right.
I don't have anything.
Okay. Moving on to board discussion, I will open it up.
A note, sometimes if there's been a demolition that's already happened or a remodel that's already happened and you want to know what it looked like, you go there and it's not there because it's been demolished. You just look on Google Earth Street View, and at least you'll get one side of it.
Okay. Yeah, and I think there was some. I think there was some actual photos of it falling down.
Yeah, there are, I believe.
Yeah.
It's the carport that always had a white Miata under it.
Yes.
Oh.
And she's been out in the rain. I have her covered, but she wants back in.
Well, the thing was falling down and starting to lean. All the posts were getting rotten up above the concrete, so we had to brace it up about a year ago. And then she decided before it fell on the car, she might have to do something.
It was old, like we get.
And I noticed you have some photos of similar carports.
Right.
Yeah.
And I have an original of what it looked like when we moved in, too.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. I think the nicest carport is the last picture. That happens to be mine.
Which I should say for the record, which did come in front of the DRB.
Which also usually has a Miata in it.
Yes.
Which
I drove here today.
Yes. Spookily similar. Right. If there are no questions or comments by the board, do we have a motion?
motion to approve application number 22-73 as submitted.
I'll second.
Okay, seconded by Mr. Green. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All against, say nay. Okay, application 22-73 passes unanimously.
And you don't have to stay for the rest of the meeting if you don't need to. In tomorrow, I'll email this stuff to Lorena, and then I'll ask her to give you a call regarding the permit.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you, everybody.
Bye-bye, thank you. Okay, moving along. Application, agenda item number 5, application 22-93, 543 East Adams. This is for a picket fence at the top of a retaining wall. Okay, and the owner like, hello, like maybe this?
Victoria Garrett.
Hello.
I hope you know one of those misled by the description in the agenda. I'm not building a 36-foot picket fence, it's just 36 inch.
Oh, I am so sorry. You know, three people looked at that.
We would say no to a 36-foot picket fence, unless it was just lawn and then...
I would as well, because I'm not...
Yeah, you're not a giant.
No.
Yeah.
You know what makes that so bad? Three people looked at this agenda for typos.
Well, we assume immediately that it's 36 inches, right?
Right, and we just looked at it wrong.
The problem overcoming is that I have a 5 to 6 foot drop-off with the retaining wall, and I'd like to put in a picket fence to prevent people from tumbling over that retaining wall. And I'd just like approval for the design, a picture of the design out of the booklet provided by the city with the pointed pickets. And I apologize for my rough draftsmanship. I'm no Photoshop expert at all. I work my way through college as a draftsman, so I drew it. I hope it's clear enough that you can understand and help you answer any questions you have about it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
We've had, well, a lot worse.
Okay. And the pickets will be wood?
They'll be wood, yes.
Yeah, okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay.
Opening this application up for public hearing or public comment. Any comments for or against the picket fence? Okay, closing the public comments. Staff comments.
I recommend this one really well. You know, this is one of those houses that was one of our local derelict houses a long time ago, and somebody with enough nerve to fix it up got in there and fixed it up. It's just like, this is one of my ones I'd like to put on the wall.
Thank you, Mr. Ward.
Everybody's giving themselves kudos tonight.
Okay, I'll open it up for board discussion. Anybody?
It's start of the new year.
That's right.
Pardon?
The start of the new year.
Yes.
Positive. Be positive.
That's great.
Yeah. Okay. Do we have a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve
22-93
as submitted.
A second.
Okay. Mr. Schriever seconds. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All against say nay. No nays. Application 22-93 passes unanimously. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, moving on agenda item number 6, 39 Howell, Pinnacle Real Estate Outdoor Lighting. Would the owner or representative like to present their case?
Good evening, board.
Good evening.
I'm Carrick Sears, and I bought the property in July. And I believe it's an absolutely beautiful building, the Gym Club Suites. And it was actually built by Frank Perkins, who was a Copper King Consolidated Mining Company architect. And what I'd like to do is showcase this great cultural gem we have in our community so that local residents and visitors alike can see it and appreciate the cultural heritage and the great detail that went into the building, that we simply don't build buildings like this again today. And we were looking through a lot of old photos, and one of the things we saw were there are two beautiful lampposts in front, right, as you go up the stairwell, and really make it look grand. And that's what I want to bring back. Sometime over the years, they disappeared, and I'm proposing that we bring back a nice light fixture on the other side of the staircase. And then also, I'd like to illuminate the beautiful metal cornices that were designed for the building, do some uplighting. And what we did a lot of research on this so that we could still be dark sky compliant. And what we found is if we mount the lights right above the window on the top floor there, with a 25-degree car floodlight, it's an LED fixture, that it would actually not go past the edge of the metal cornice, and it would stay, the light would stay underneath the roof. And so that's what we proposed to do, so that we could illuminate the building at night and not have any lighting going up into the sky and keep it all under the cornice.
Can I quickly ask you a question again? Where is the light strip? This is a strip lighting, right?
No, rather than doing a strip light, what we proposed is a little light fixture that I included a tear sheet on in the package.
You can go into that in just a second, but where was it going to be located again on the building?
Yeah, just above the window, at the edge of the brick on the top floor.
You photoshopped it in.
I photoshopped little light fixtures on top.
Sorry, I didn't notice that.
And it's on all...
Yeah, it'd be five on one side and three on the other side, so a total of eight fixtures.
I'm sorry to interrupt you. Please continue.
No worries. I think that really concludes what I have to say. Are there any other questions?
Thank you. Appreciate it. Okay,
thank you.
Okay, I will open up application 22-95 for public comment, for or against. Okay, closing public comment, opening up for staff comments.
The lighting on the building, this actually the gym club building is one of the most beautiful, if not the most beautiful in my opinion. I love that building. And lighting it up would be very pretty. And this is outside of what you guys do. I'm not sure that that's permissible under the light pollution code been adopted, but that's outside of what you guys do.
Okay.
And I'm not certain that it will or won't.
Okay, thank you.
I've got a comment.
Okay, well, I'm going to open it up for board discussion.
Oh, okay, right. Sorry.
Yeah, so opening up for board discussion, Mr. Schriever.
I was walking in the parking lot the other day, and after being in the evening, coming back from, I think, a concert. And I don't see how these small little canister lights, illuminating the rafters underneath is going to harm anything. I think it would enhance the building. I noticed, so far as light compliancy, there was more light coming out of the windows that people were in the room. Mm-hmm. In the rooms, the windows that were lit. I do not see that this is going to interfere, but actually enhance the building in the evening. That's my comment.
Thank you, Mr. Schriever. Anyone else?
I have a question. The light is only going up, correct? Or is it going up and down?
Just up.
The lamp posts that you're proposing to put in,
yes.
Those concrete pillars, are they currently there? Are they?
The concrete pillars are there. There's no light on top of them.
So you're just going to replace the ones that were on top of those pillars, right?
With something very similar as I can find.
Okay, I was just curious whether those pillars were actually still existing.
They are, correct.
Thank you.
Have you searched around any architectural salvage places like in Chicago, Detroit, San Francisco? They might have the exact same ones that were there. Just something to consider.
so far we've looked in Arizona and have not come up with anything, so that's why we went online to find something similar.
Because, you know, after shipping, since these are cast aluminum, the price might be the same. So I would, that's actually more a comment to the other board members.
No, you're talking about the, not, you're not talking about these lights.
No, yeah, sorry, I'm talking about the two.
Yeah, the lighthouse, right.
Okay.
And do you know if this, these canister lights came in a white finish? Or if you could make
them. They can be any color we want. So oil rub bronze, I thought would, I want to do the least noticeable, so perhaps it might be white to match the window, which we could do.
I would prefer that.
Yeah.
I do feel like this looks very modern and that it does impact the look of the windows, which are beautiful. If it was white, I think it would blend right in and you wouldn't see it.
Can we stipulate then that it matches the actual surface it's going to be mounted to? Because if it's green color, we don't want white up here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if it ends up having to be mounted on the brick, we could do it a brick red. If it ends up being on the window, we can do it the white.
Can we do that since we're not...
You can.
Yes, we can. We can stipulate that.
Since we're not really in charge of color.
No, you can make that.
Because it's the aesthetics that you wanted to, the finish of the windows.
So we could say painted to match.
Okay.
As the finish.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I mean, I think these light posts, they're cool. You know, they look old.
Yeah, I'm happy with posts, and I'm actually, I prefer bronze, but that's my opinion.
Mm-hmm. I mean, these were different, obviously. They were, I think...
That's like one of my concerns. You know, the National Parks code say, you know, you don't want an imitation unless you know that's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
And that it's actually antique versus, you know, a caricature that kind of looks like it. They would rather that it be moderner at some time, so.
Yeah, I think this looks really different from these, from the original ones, which seem to be, you know, concrete or something.
And I think it's my understanding that you haven't really decided on which lamppost to purchase yet. Is that
right? This point I wanted permission to do it. It's my goal to find something as similar as we can, whether that be from an old scrapyard or we have to go out and buy it.
Do you have like any higher resolution photos of?
I do not. That was the best one we had.
And that's, was that from mining and disposal museum?
When it was the YMCA. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, because staff asked the same question, and he was like, that was the only resolution I had when I got it from the museum.
Okay. We can make a stipulation to that, can't we?
I mean, so if you went to that museum, you know, that's as close as we could get, you know, unless I've got a pretty huge archive of photos, I can more than happy to look through. That actually the new head of the museum, Andy Larkin, gave me. But see if I have high resolution stuff there. But I think from what I can see in the photo, they are pretty close. Perhaps they were painted a little bit different, but I would just make an attempt to find out. An actual one from 1903. Yeah. Yep. Or like that time period, 1910, 1900.
Any other comments by the board?
I wonder if in 1903 they were gas lights.
Yeah, you have some gas lights.
And we're not going to try and make you put gas
lights. We're not going to gaslight you on
this. I actually thought about that. I thought that'd be really cool.
It would be rather nice, but a spherical shade like that,
right.
Probably not, because they'd need a chimney if it was a gas light.
Right.
So I think your electric answer is the one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right. If there are no more questions, I'm closing the board discussion. Do we have a motion?
I make a motion to approve as submitted 2295.
Okay, no stipulation on the color of the...
Nope, I'll let somebody else...
Do we have a second?
I'll second.
Okay, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All against say nay. Nay.
Nay.
Two nays. We have four ayes and two nays. Application 22-95 passes. So, there we go.
And I'm sorry, did Mr. Green, you said, you seconded that, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
All right, moving along. Agenda item number 7. Application 22-96, Main Street Parking Lot. And this is an application to build a, place a prefabricated miner shack in the parking lot. And can we hear from the applicant? Thank you.
Hello, I'm Dale Turner. I have, just a little history of me over 20 years ago. I bought into the Border Cities Land Company, and that building was run down, had broken windows, needed painting badly, and I put together a plan to fix it up and revitalize it. And they agreed, the other owners did. I loaned the money to them, and which has since been paid back. And that's when that building got fixed up, because it was it greets the people coming to town, and I thought it was a nice store, but there was no funds to fix it up. So that's what I've done in the past. And this parking lot is, although it's still owned by the Border Cities Land Company, I've got a proposal to buy it. And I have endured the gravel ugliness of that lot for 20 years, but it also greets people coming in town. And so I was responsible for getting it fixed up recently. And, you know, the lines in the lot are 9 feet wide instead of 8 or 8.5 to make it a, you know, a lot that's easy to park in. And so what I need a parking lot building, you know, the store, signage in, other things. And for someone to stay in when we do have an attendant there that's not in the sun. So that's my proposal, is to put a building that's modeled after a miner shack, a typical building with a galvanized roof. The normal wavy ones, whatever you call it.
Corrugated.
Corrugated, that's it. Heard it earlier. And to put siding on it. It could be any way, but the siding on a lot of the old houses was, you know, just the wood siding on it. I plan on Mr. Shedd building it for me, and then there will be some things we'll have to finish up once we get it, because it's not, they're not used to putting siding on their buildings, and so we can do that ourselves and get it fixed up. So, you know, we haven't settled on, I know you guys don't, gals and guys don't approve colors, but, you know, we'll try to make it so it blends in, not a colorful building.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Appreciate it. I will open public comments or public hearing. Any comments for or against this application? Nothing? Okay. Staff comments?
Yeah.
I think what Mr.
Wait.
Mr.
Sorry. You have to declare the public hearing closed.
Okay.
Sorry.
Declare the public hearing closed. Staff comments?
I think what Mr. Turner proposed is appropriate.
Thank you. Mr. Ward? Anybody else? Okay. All right.
You mean Mr. Davis?
Huh?
Did you say Mr. Did you let Mr. Davis?
No. I said thank you, Mr. Ward.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Board discussion is open.
I have a question for the applicant. Is this building going to be fixed to the ground, or is it going to be movable?
My plan was to make it movable.
Yeah.
I mean, it's going to be brought in and put
sure.
down.
And I vaguely remember, certainly in the last 10 years or so, there was a similar structure right there.
Yes, it was. And that was someone else who was running the lot back then, and then when they were not running anymore, they took their structure out.
They took it with them.
And that structure was approved as by the design review as a minor shack.
Yeah, and it was described as being on a sled. I might have actually been at that application. Okay, that was my question answered. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Green. Okay, but to me, this looks like a tough shed, like that you would buy from Home Depot and put in your backyard or to store things. So is it gonna look like this, or is...
Which one are you looking at, Miles?
I'm looking at these drawings right here, and it says you're gonna use hardy plank boards that look like painted wood.
This one is in there, too.
Yeah.
That's a tough shed that I dressed up.
That's a tough shed, right, because I don't think this would be appropriate.
But this is the one I was going for. I just don't have the drawing skills to put it together.
And...
Isn't this one in there?
Yeah, it is.
It is in there. No, it is. It is. I was just looking at this because I thought, you know, that to me doesn't look like it would be.
So what aspects of it, of that tough shed, that's what he's starting with, would you change or would you take out or add?
Well, if you're calling it a minor shack should look like wood.
Yeah.
Right? And he does have double hung windows, so, or single hung windows there. But, it just shouldn't look like this, you know, that plastic or whatever material to make these tough sheds out of.
No, he's going to...
2111%.
Is that what it is?
Something like that.
Yeah, and it's a different company that makes it, and when they make it, we're going to have to add the siding ourselves.
Okay.
You know, because it's... I agree with the tough shed look, and I've looked at all the buildings out there, and there's none that we could modify to make it look right. So we're starting from scratch.
Okay. Yeah, I mean that. To me, that's also appropriate.
You said Mr. Shed is building this for you?
Yeah, the people in Wichita City, that's who's quoted me on it so far.
Are these stock photos from Mr. Shed?
I took them off the internet. I don't think so. I think they're... I asked them if they would do me a sketch, and they weren't willing to help me with that.
Right, because we don't really know what it looks like. I mean, I like this as an idea, you know, but it's hard to see what it looks like. Anybody else?
I have, and this is just my open gut reaction to looking at it. It just looks like it was brought off the lot of Lowe's for Home Depot.
Well, right, that's
and I don't know.
Well, that's because that's just a stock photo of where he probably got it from, but the shed won't look like that, will it? No, because he has to put his own siding. It'll just be the frame, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right. He just gave us stock photos of what the sizing and everything of it, but he'll put the siding on it himself.
I did say my initial gut reaction.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and that's the application that I'm looking at. So
there's a drawing in there, I believe that he.
This is the drawing.
Yeah.
Okay. No, I did have it.
And sir, you're using a metal roof.
Mm-hmm. That will certainly help.
Mm-hmm. It's a corrugated metal? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Which I think we have to put on that too.
Yeah, I think it's going to look good.
Okay.
I think if you just make some stipulations of what you'd like to see.
I mean, the easiest thing generally is to make it look like board and batten, put vertical battens on it. Which isn't what you drew horizontal. It's generally the easiest way I've seen these things get converted to have that look. And generally the minor shacks, the true ones, were board and batten. Then they put horizontal siding on later as a luxury upgrade. So you know, if it wants to be a miner shack, I think vertical board and batten with corrugated roof. And the diagonal things on the posts look like kind of cartoonish over, kind of overcompensation. You know, I'd probably remove those if they're not structural, those diagonal. None of the miner shack here have that. But I think that would be probably a really low effort way of making it actually look like a miner shack.
Yeah, but actually, board and batten would be actually less expensive than what I was planning to do. And so I'm happy to do it either way. I prefer the other way, but I'm not talking about historically, I just, but I'm happy with board and batten.
Okay, great. Do we, any more comments from the board? Do we have a motion?
And you wanna make that motion?
Make a motion to approve 22-96 with vertical board and batten and corrugated roofing and without the diagonals on the posts.
I second. All in favor, say aye.
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 Okay, any nays? No nays? We have six in favor. It passes unanimously with the stipulation previously stated. Thank you.
Ben, what did you say those things were called in your motion? You said with vertical board and batten, corrugated metal roof, and what?
The diagonals on the posts.
No diagonals.
Okay, no diagonals.
I never thought of that before, but you're quite right.
Yeah, I mean, never. The only time you see is on mining shoring or something.
Yeah, they save you some money.
Yeah.
Can I ask you a question?
Okay.
Just to be clear, this is what you're talking about?
Yeah, those, yeah, they're a little cartoony.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sorry, I had to have a
Oh, no, that's good.
You explained it to me too, because I'm like, I heard what he said, I think.
Yeah, you did hear what he said. Okay, moving on to agenda item eight, approval of the December 7, 2022 Design Review Board meeting minutes. Do we have a motion?
Yes.
Okay, Mr. Gaffer has a motion to approve. Do we have a second?
I'll second it.
Mr. Perfect seconds. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Agenda item eight passes unanimously, or is approved.
Thank you so much.
Agenda item number nine, discussion regarding the submittal requirements for the Design Review Board application packet currently versus before. Anybody?
Mr. Green wanted this discussion.
Okay. Yes. Thank you, Mr. Green.
I threw this out because we put a lot of work into redoing the questionnaire and the application form and the tick boxes and everything else.
Yes.
And then just 3 or 4 meetings ago, we received an application that was wildly deficient in many areas. And it ended up getting approved. And it made me think, well, you know what? All that work was wasted because none of what we said was required was adhered to, and yet we still, as a board, allowed it to go through. And I thought it was time to talk about that, because otherwise we're undermining our own authority by passing deficient applications.
Do you recall what it was for?
Specifically, it was a property on Brewery Avenue. Well, Youngblood.
Youngblood. Oh, the Youngblood.
It was the 223C.
Yeah. I mean, that's one, but there were others. And historically, there were a lot like that. You know, applications written on the back of cigarette packets.
Right, right.
That went through.
Yes.
And, you know, we really have got to get a hold on that. And that's what I want us to discuss.
I am 100% in agreement with my colleague. However, I would also add that since that particular application, NINA has been distributing sneak previews of the applications. So I think we now do have that ability
to make comments, which I have done on a couple of occasions.
And matter of fact, I just sent one out today and letting you know that I requested it. I haven't received it yet. But if there's anything else you would like to see, let me know.
That was pretty lightweight, but I haven't had a chance to really get into it. So I think the onus is probably now on the board, if we accept that, to, you know, have that first review. Not for whether we're going to pass it or not, but for completeness and accuracy and so forth.
Right.
So, and that has been implemented in the last couple of months.
Yes.
And I appreciate that.
Oh,
very much.
Absolutely
makes
welcome.
Work for you, I'm sure.
It does, but you know what? It helps in the long run, because then I don't have to keep chasing something. I know exactly what you're looking for. I don't have to try to figure it out. I can say, you know, the board may ask for something else. You know, this is what we've asked for, but the board may ask for something else, is what I tell them when they turn it in now. And they know that I give you a week. I think you see, I try to give it, like, if I give it out on a Tuesday, you tell me on a Tuesday. If it's a Wednesday, you tell me on a Wednesday. And I, most people have been very appreciative of that and grateful.
But you've got a good response.
Absolutely. Good. Like, they're like, oh, okay. Because I think that there is a misconception, I think, that you do not look at the applications, which is not true. And I've tried to express that to them.
It's also good to give them advance notice that they need to complete this.
Correct. And the reason I give a week time frame is it gives me enough time to get back to them and give them a time frame to get that information prior to the meeting.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, that's good. And the way it's distributed electronically, and basically wherever we are, we can look at it, and if there's some wild deficiency,
right,
we can flag it and just
right.
Say, hey, you know, they haven't given us a site plan.
Right.
Or whatever.
Or whatever they need.
Right. I mean, since you've started doing it, I haven't seen anything that, I think one of them was missing a couple of photographs and they supplemented them.
Yes, right.
So I think because we have this, we now have rules.
Right.
That we have, therefore, grounds to say, no, you haven't obeyed the rules.
Right.
So that's my sort of opinion. I have a different comment, but but that's just me. But I didn't want to change the subject yet.
Oh, yeah, no.
Okay.
So the only thing that I was slightly concerned about, and I may need to read this three or four more times, but I think, Ben, you contributed this.
Yes.
And it's brilliant. And I've seen people obviously do it literally, I think, a couple tonight. And it does work. My concern is that someone will do it and get away with it and say, well, you know, you proved it. Do we make it clear that if you're going to give us a brand new or a complete overhaul of a house, we need more than this? Is that, or do you think, I mean, this is a question really for Ben, do you think that this, if done right, your method would actually cover virtually all, except for obviously new build? We don't get many of those.
You're referring to this?
Yeah.
This drawing,
I mean,
here?
Yeah, and some people are doing it, and I, you know, it's clearly, I mean, I think the applicant for the carport tonight literally gave us a transparency.
Yes.
Is cool. Taking it to the next level, yeah.
Right.
But it was beautiful. It was well done. But anyway, I just don't want to...
I'd say we just keep an eye on it.
Okay.
It's worked good so far, but if they start getting sloppy or whatever, you know, we treat them like... It's
okay.
Maybe we should say for minor alterations, a method that could be used rather than a complete remodel of a whole house.
So this one is...
Yeah.
Is this the one you're talking about?
Yeah. Yes.
And put on there what now? I'm sorry.
For minor alterations.
I mean, it works beautifully if you're just changing out windows because...
Yeah, just changing windows.
Okay. I can add that wording to it.
Window.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not on the...
No. But what we can do is, for the next, I can add that to the next agenda for your approval.
Sure.
But, yeah. And if there was anything else.
Yeah, because, I mean, the intent here is for small projects, we don't want the application to cost more than the project itself, which can't happen.
Yeah.
So I'll put that on there for the next time, on the February meeting.
Okay. Anything else on the application? Okay, closing out agenda item number nine, do we have any staff comments?
I don't have any comments, but I just listed the administrative approvals that have been done.
Yeah.
For, and I've tried to tell you, you know, there was a roof, and then one of the applications that you'll hear next month is actually, will be dated 2281, because they turned it in, then went on vacation, and then let me know they were gonna be another month out.
Okay.
So I was like, that's fine, so I just wanted to let you know that the numbers will be off a little bit, but not by much, it's just because he turned it in prior to the new year, thought he was gonna be here for the January meeting, and won't be back into Bisbee until February.
Okay.
Maybe you can just remind us when that comes up.
Oh, it'll be on the next one, yeah, it'll be on the next one.
Remind us when that comes up.
Yeah, so I just wanted to let you know the numbers that were missing off the agenda.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
Any future agenda item suggestions? I think we just had one, but anything else? Okay. I think.
No.
No?
Are you sure?
Sure.
Are you sure? It looked like you had one.
Like you had something.
You're biting.
I might have something.
Okay, go ahead.
Now, I missed a few meetings, and maybe I missed something, but did we ever approve the new guidelines?
Yes.
Okay.
October.
Yeah.
Alright, thanks.
I will tell you, they are still with the planning and zoning.
Okay.
So we're not gonna discuss it, but I just will let you know that they're still with the planning and zoning, and they'll be next Thursday, they'll be looking at them again.
Okay.
Does it require legal review?
It does, but he wanted whatever their suggestion, all of it to be made at one time.
Okay.
And then it'll be submitted again to him.
Do you think there will be a lot of changes?
I don't know, I think they just are.
They found a few things that were, but were helpful.
Yeah, that were helpful, but not, you know.
Nothing that was really, you know, major.
Nothing major.
But there was some I's that weren't dotted.
Yeah.
Right, okay. Good.
So hopefully this next time they'll finish it up, and then we can move it on to the next phase of it.
So Joe, how many years ago was that first came up for discussion?
Six years. Three years of.
A long time coming, a long time needed.
2016 maybe?
Yeah.
As long as I've been on the board.
You have nothing, are you sure? Okay, Mr. Gaffer, what do you have?
Peter, you look like you're fighting your.
He does, he's kind of.
I'm gonna say something.
Okay.
Lori and I are putting together, which is a requirement, an annual report.
Yes.
It's in draft form, and I don't know whether, and I defer to Chair to say whether it is something that the Chair wants to distribute in draft form to other members of the board or not. It's your call, Lori.
I would absolutely want to do that.
In which case, after you've finished with it, why don't you send it to Nina, and then Nina will have to officially distribute it.
Okay, if you send me the electronic version, then I can forward. Okay, that sounds great.
Right.
Yeah. Okay, if there's nothing else, I'll make a motion to adjourn. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. This meeting is adjourned.